So today we are going to discuss the catalytic hydrogenation. So before we are going to discuss the whole catalytic hydrogenation, so let us try to define the word by word. So hydrogenation is addition of hydrogen across a double bond, or addition of, we can define in other words, addition of hydrogen to a hydrogen deficient part of the molecule. So for example, hydrogen deficient part is actually alkene. So that is alkyne. Nitrile group, keto group, acid chloride. So these are hydrogen deficient part of the molecule. So this is hydrogen deficient part. This part is actually hydrogen deficient part. So therefore we can add the hydrogen to the hydrogen deficient part. It's called as a hydrogenation. So now we can carry out the hydrogenations in the presence of a catalyst. Now the addition of hydrogens can be carried out. Addition of hydrogen can be carried out in the presence of a catalyst, we call it as catalytic hydrogenation. So say for example, we are carrying out this. So this is CH2, this will be CH3. So the hydrogens will be added, one is here, another hydrogens will be added. So we need to convert an alkene into alkene, an hydrocarbon, and unsaturated into a saturated. So in these reactions with the help of a catalyst, the hydrogenations can be carried out with the conditions of 1 to 30 atmospheric pressures. And alkene is converted into alkene. So this is what we call it as catalytic hydrogenations. Now the catalytic hydrogenation is of two types. So one is homogeneous catalytic hydrogenation. So another is heterogeneous catalytic hydrogenation. So homogeneous means the reactant and catalyst and solvent, they are in one phase. Reactant, catalyst, solvent and one phase. So they are called as homogeneous catalytic hydrogenation. So heterogeneous catalytic hydrogenation means the reactant, catalyst, reactant, so this catalyst, hydrogen, this and reactant plus solvent, catalyst and hydrogen, they are in one phase and this is in liquid phase. This is actually solid phase. see what they will do is, a catalyst is a transition metals, a transition metal which is adsorbed on a solid surface. Adsorbed on a solid surface. To the transition metal, the hydrogen will be adsorbed. So this forms a solid surface, solid phase, and the reactant as well as solvent will actually forms another phase. Now from the reactant phase, that is from the solvent phase, the reactant will diffuse to the solid phase, where the reactions will occur, catalytic hydrogenations will occur. Heterogeneous, because this is more applicable, heterogeneous catalytic hydrogenations. Heterogeneous catalytic hydrogenation. So here in this case, the transition metal, usually a transition metal, and this will act as a catalyst, will be adsorbed onto a solid surface. Okay, solid surface or solid support. Surface or support. Now the transition metals are usually we are going to use in the catalytic hydrogenation: palladium, platinum, rhodium, nickel, and solid support is actually charcoal, alumina, and silica. So this are the solid support. Now the palladium is adsorbed onto a solid support, in which the palladium will be contacted with hydrogen. So it's like this: hydrogen will be contacted with the palladium. Palladium is in contact with the charcoal, that is carbon. Now this is how the catalytic hydrogenation will work. Now the solvent that we are using in the catalytic hydrogenation, that is heterogeneous, is methanol, ethanol, ethyl acetate, acetic acid, diethyl ether, and hexane. So this is the solvent that we are using in the catalytic hydrogenation reactions. Now we have different catalytic agents. We are depending upon the nature of the catalyst and the nature of the solid support. So with respect to the decreasing order, so first hydrogen, that is metal, is rhodium, adsorbed on alumina. So this is highly active catalyst for the hydrogenation purpose. So another is hydrogen, platinum adsorbed on carbon, that is charcoal. Another is hydrogen, palladium carbon, palladium charcoal, hydrogen with Ra nickel. So this is more active, so the order, activity order, will be decreasing. Now with respect to the functional group, that the decreasing order of reactivity. So highly reactive molecule is actually acid chloride. Next is hydro group. Next is alkene. Next is alkyne. So next is keto group. Next is nitrile group. So nitrile is less reactive. And for the conversion of nitrile to an amine using this radium Raney nickel is very very difficult. It requires high temperature. The activity is less. The reactivity functional group is also less. Then it requires high temperature and high pressure in order to carry out catalytic hydrogenation. We take an example with reference to the reactivity. Reference to the reactivity and activity. So if you take the hydrogenation of naphthalene by using Raney nickel catalyst at 150 degrees Celsius, it will carry out a partial reduction. So one of the ring retains aromaticity. But the same molecule will be carried out at 200 degrees Celsius. As the temperature increases, the reactivity also increases. It will make decaline. So this is naphthalene, this is decaline. Now the properties of this heterogeneous catalysis. Properties of heterogeneous catalytic hydrogenation. This is heterogeneous catalytic hydrogenation. It actually reduces olefins. It reduces olefins and acetylenes. Reduces olefins and acetylenes to saturated hydrocarbons. And another important thing is that this hydrogenation is sensitive. It is sensitive to stearic effect and choice of the solvent. So which solvent we are going to choose, whether it is a polar solvent or a non-polar solvent. Choice of the solvent. And polar functional groups. Next point is actually polar functional group such as OH group or COOR group actually decides the direction of the delivery of hydrogen. Decides the direction of delivering not oxygen, hydrogen. Now the catalytic hydrogenation, that is heterogeneous catalytic hydrogenation, always syn addition, that is the addition of hydrogen always in the same phase. Addition of hydrogen is always same phase. Now the solvent reactivity. So if more polar, more reactive, less polar, less reactive. More polar, more reactive. Less polar, less reactive. So the order of reactivity will be hexane, will be lesser than ethyl acetate, which is lesser than ethanol, which is lesser than acetic acid, which is lesser than acetic acid and HCl. So this is HCl is more reactive and HCl is less reactive. So because of the polarity, polar nature. Now we will try to discuss the mechanism of this hydrogenation. Mechanism of this catalytic hydrogenation. So first we have a solid surface, that is a catalyst adsorbed on a solid surface. Now to this the hydrogen will be adsorbed on this solid surface. So this is hydrogen will be adsorbed. So in the next phase we have alkene will be present in the solution phase, that will travel to a solid phase, and this is a metal. So the metal will interact the pi star orbital will interact the pi electron cloud of the reactant or alkene. So we'll get, this is hydrogen, this is hydrogen. Okay, now this will interact, it will make a bond with the surface, solid surface, through transition metals. Now once it is locked in a certain conformation, certain positions, favoring positions, this alkene, now what will happen, the hydrogens will be transferred. Once the hydrogen is transferred, the pi electron cloud shifted to the neighboring carbon, through the neighboring carbon atom it forms a bond, a sigma bond. Now it's a pi donations, before that it is a pi donation. Now after transferring the hydrogens, it forms a sigma bond with the a solid support. Next case, so now the hydrogens will be transferred. Now here we have this, this is hydrogen. Now we have one more hydrogen here, and this hydrogen will be transferred. So because here this carbon donates to the transition metal, so therefore it is electron deficient, hydride will be transferred. Once hydride is transferred, this bond breaks down. So we will get H. Now this is the hydrogen is transferred during the hydrogenation reactions. They are in the syn phase, syn addition. So therefore the addition of hydrogen is always the same phase addition of hydrogen. Now the functional group conversions through catalytic hydrogenation. What are the functional group we can convert? Functional group conversion through heterogeneous catalytic hydrogenation. First one is RCOCl, and the order will be the decreasing order of reactivity. RCOCl will be converted into RCHO through catalytic hydrogenations, and RNO2 converted into RNH2, and RC triple bond CR is converted into, so in this case we will get cis alkene. Now the aldehyde will be converted into a primary alcohol, RCH2OH. Now alkene will be converted into alkane. Along with hydrogen. Now the ketone will be converted into secondary alcohol. Now this is a decreasing order of reactivity. This will undergo up to keto So up to keto, this whole functional group transformations will be facile, will be reactive and easy to hydrogenate, easy to carry out catalytic hydrogenation. So because of the high reactivity of the functional group, catalytic hydrogenation. So but after the keto group, it's very difficult to carry out the catalytic hydrogenations due to the lack of reactivity. So similarly in naphthalene, and ester group, COOR group, RCH2OH, ROH, amide is very susceptible to undergo catalytic hydrogenation. Next, RCOO minus, though this is inert, will not undergo catalytic hydrogenations. That is carboxylic acid will not undergo catalytic hydrogenation. Example for the catalytic hydrogenation. So we can carry out this with platinum hydrogen, so which is adsorbed on the carbon or aluminium. So usually platinum is adsorbed on carbon. Now here the hydrogens will be transferred so the methyl group will be in the same positions, so therefore we will get cis geometry. So this is 70% plus, we will get trans, but this is 30%. Now the attack of hydrogen through this bond, hydrogen will be transferred here, and the transfer of hydrogens to the alkene bond decided by the neighboring group also. Now the neighboring group decides the stereochemical aspects of the product. If it is above the plane, this methyl group is also above the plane. Now another example, this is CH3 hydrogen, palladium, carbon. Now in this example we can expect the exo approach, endo as well as exo. So if it is exo, the methyl group will be, both are below the plane, so below, so that therefore we will get trans. Both are below, we'll get trans. If both are above, we'll get trans. If it is once, one below, one above, we'll get cis. So therefore, the exo we will get, the exo approach, the hydrogen delivers through the exo approach. So therefore, we will get the product. This is methyl group. This is methyl group. The hydrogen will be in these positions. So this is exo product, is the measured product. Now another example. OH. Hydrogen, palladium, carbon, that is charcoal. So in this case, you can see there is a polar group OH. So if it is a polar OH group or electron donating group, then the hydrogen will be on the same stereochemistry of the polar group. So hydrogen will be added, attached in the same phase as the polar group is present. So we will get H, get OH. You can see the same. So another example. Now this is OME. There is a bond here. This is OH, hydrogen, palladium, carbon. Now this is above the plane, so therefore the hydrogenation is taking place. Okay, in these reactions the OH is actually above the plane, so therefore we will get the hydrogenation is also above the plane, same side. So here we have this OH, the double bond here, we get alkenes is converted into alkanes, unsaturations converted into saturated carbon atom. Now we will take similar example, but electron withdrawing group. If electron withdrawing group are present, CO2ME, there is a double bond, here it is OME, hydrogen, palladium, carbon. So we will get, this is electron withdrawing group. So if it is electron withdrawing group, opposite to that phase. If it is below the plane, hydrogenations will be carried out above the plane. So this will be unaffected. So another example. So we have OH, so this is below the plane, nickel hydrogen. So this is electron withdrawing group. We can write here, we will write. So here it is H. OH is below the plane, H is also below. Hydrogenation is also taking place in below the plane. Now some a type of reduction reactions in the catalytic hydrogenation reaction, that is Rosenmund reduction or Rosenmund reduction. So in the Rosenmund reduction, the halides, acid chlorides are converted into aldehydes to catalytic hydrogenations, say for example RCOCl. So Rosenmund catalytic hydrogenating is actually hydrogen palladium supported on barium sulfate, it will be converted into RCHO. So this is a Rosenmund reactions. So here, in order to stop the reactions at the aldehyde state, we are using a catalytic poison, so that is guanoline, and this actually poisons the catalyst. Poisoning means it decreases the activity of the catalyst, Now another reaction is actually another catalyst, that is Lindlar catalyst. Lindlar catalyst. So Lindlar catalyst is the palladium and calcium carbonate. Palladium and calcium carbonate. So Lindlar catalyst actually hydrogenate alkyne. R dash R, so it is actually cis alkene. So Lindlar catalyst actually hydrogenate alkyne to cis alkene. So another example, CO2Me. This is alkyne. So this is extensively used for to convert alkyne into alkene. So we'll get, this is double bond. So this is cis hydrogenation. Yes. Homogeneous catalytic hydrogenation. So in homogeneous catalytic hydrogenations, all the reactants catalyst hydrogen, so all in the same phase, that is in the liquid phase, same phase. So this is a lot of demerits in homogeneous catalysis. So because the isolation of the product is very difficult. Compared to heterogeneous. Now one of the here we don't use, we are not using any solid surface. But we are using a complex in organometallic complex or metallic compound or a coordination complex we are using in order to carry out homogeneous catalytic hydrogenation. Now one of the catalyst that is taking place in the homogeneous is actually Wilkinson catalyst. So Wilkinson catalyst is actually rhodium chloride triphenyl phosphine. So this is Wilkinson catalyst. It's a homogeneous catalyst. So this Wilkinson catalyst is actually hydrogenate at less hindered site. So it hydrogenate at less hindered site. Say for example, this is actually the, we have to, this is more hindered, and this is less hindered, and if we carry out the hydrogenation reactions, hydrogen, now we will get OH. So this is the product. So we can take examples of this Wilkinson catalyst. Now this OH, we have a double bond here, and this is just a OME, and we are carrying out hydrogenations with Wilkinson catalyst. Hydrogen ethanol. So we'll get, now this is actually electron donating group, hydrogenation taking place in the same side as the polar functional group. So with respect to rhodium is also in the same side. One more example. This is CO2ME, OME, rhodium chloride, triphenyl phosphine, tristriphenyl phosphine, hydrogen in ethanol solution, that is solvent. Now this is electron withdrawing, so therefore hydrogenation is in antiphase with respect to that polar group, OME. H CO2ME above the plane, this is below the plane. Rhodium chloride, triphenyl phosphine, ethanol as a solvent. So now in this case, so this is less hindered compared to this. So this group will, this alkene will undergo hydrogenation reaction. Triphenyl phosphine, ethanol. And this is more hindered one, more hindered, this is less hindered. So this will undergo hydrogenation reaction. So this is the product. Now the reactivity order with respect to reactivity order with respect to Wilkinson catalyst is as follows. So this is more reactive, the mono substituted one, then the disubstituted at one of the olefinic carbon, which is more reactive than the disubstituted on both the side. Next is one trisubstituted, one is disubstituted, another olefinic carbon is mono substituted. Now finally is actually this is, so this is with the decreasing order of reactivity with respect to the Wilkinson catalyst. Now the mechanism of this Wilkinson catalyst, the mechanism. The structure of Wilkinson catalyst is, this is the structure of Wilkinson catalyst. Now first it will undergo oxidative addition reaction. Now this is rhodium 1, it undergoes addition of hydrogen. This is, we call it as oxidative addition reaction, rhodium Cl PPH3. एच एच पी पी एच थ्री. Now this is 3, so rhodium 1 goes to rhodium 3, oxidative addition reactions. So here what will happen is that the hydrogen, the HH bond get broken off. So it's broken off, why? Because it donates, in order to form a coordinate bond, it donates through sigma electron, that is why it's called a sigma donation. And while back, pi back donations, while donating by the metal through pi back, now it doesn't have a capacity to hold the pi electron, that is why that actually ruptures the hydrogen bond, that is why we will get hydrogen attached separately to the rhodium metal. Now in the next step it loses one of the ligand, PPH3. Rhodium HCl so it has a vacant site. Now this is actually create a vacant site by the loss of a ligand. Now with respect to the vacant site, the alkenes will be attached to rhodium through its pi electron cloud, H, H, Cl, PH3. So now this hydrogen will be transferred to one of the olefinic carbon, and the pi electron close to the another carbon, that carbon attached to rhodium. Now we'll get rhodium now connected with the carbon. Now this is hydrogen, this is R group. Okay, now we have hydrogen, we have Cl, we have PH3, PPH3, we have PPH3. So now in the next step, this hydride will be transferred to another carbon and this will be attached to rhodium again. Now that create a vacant site, again PPH3 will attack and regenerate the catalyst. Again rhodium, Cl, H3, PH3, again it is 1, rhodium 1. Again addition of PPH3 regenerate the catalyst. Now what is eliminated is actually this HHR. So hydrogens will be attached to on the same side, so we will get 6 configurations. So this is with respect to the Wilkinson catalyst. Now some of the worked example with respect to catalytic hydrogenation, homogeneous as well as heterogeneous. With respect to heterogeneous, this is methyl, this is methyl, hydrogen, platinum, carbon. So we will get the product methyl group. So you will get 70 to 80% of the product. CH2, charcoal, platinum is absorbed on charcoal, so you will get methyl group hydrogen. So with respect to Wilkinson catalyst, it's a very important example. This is methyl group. rhodium chloride, triphenyl phosphine, D2. Instead of hydrogens, we are actually taking D2 deuterium. Now this will get the addition of deuterium. D, you will get D here. The remaining portions will be same, and this is D production can be done with acid hydrolysis. Now you will get carbonyl group, this is methyl group, this is deuterium.